Hello everybody, I know I have not posted a tutorial in a long time, but I figured that I would do it today because I just downloaded Rocket Dock for Vista and I changed the theme and everything. I wanted to show you how you can actually download Rocket Dock. I love the this program. I really love Windows Vista. I mean, not in particular Vista, but I really love the Mac, and I want to show everybody who doesn't know anything really about Vista, Mac, how they can start to get the Macintosh on Vista. So first we're gonna go to rocketdock.com. Okay, and then you're gonna want to go right here to the download. Now this is for Vista. They also have a little video explaining how to do these things.
Alright, I'm Skunky from Postcore. I write all the documentation and answer all the questions.
Anyways, so you're just gonna go to download and you wanna click on the latest version they have, which is version 1.315. Now, since I've already done this, I'm not gonna do it. You just hit run. So I'm gonna pop over to here, and I'm gonna show you some things that you can do in the settings. Some things that you can do is, in general, you can run at startup. You can minimize Windows to the dock. You can do running application indicators. You can open running application instance. You can lock the items. So on the icons, you can do either one of these. I personally like the default. The opacity you can change. As you can see, it'll get a lot lighter if I changed it. Now I'm changing it back, it's the same. Now, the zoom cue. You have to remember what you've had this on, because once you hit the default, you're going to have to do everything all over again. So mine is 48%, or 48 pixels, and I have to remember that. Okay, so 48 pixels. And the size is how big the dock is, so I'm going to go back to 48 pixels. Okay. Now, for the zoom, I'm just going to... If you want, you can do a flat, and it goes up and down like that. There's a plateau, where it just kind of zooms out in a huge thing. Then there's a bubble, where it's the exact, close to the exact same thing as a plateau. Then there's a no zoom, where it just has a little hover sign next to it. Alright, and so you can just mess with these. I'm not going to, I'm going to keep mine at none for right now. Now the position, you can always change by simply right-clicking it and going to position and changing it that way. Now the layering, always on top, you want to be normal. I would want to be normal because I don't want it to, you know, always be on top of my windows. Like right now it is because you're in the settings. Okay, so centering, I just leave alone. If you want it all the way up here, it would be negative 100. All the way down here is positive 100, and 0 is just in the center. So the edge offset is how far out it will go. I just changed mine to 128. Now, if you can tell that over here on the scroll bar, it'll still do it. Okay, I'm gonna put mine back to 0. Well, I'm gonna put mine back all the way to the edge. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and hit default. Because I want it back and I don't know where it is. Okay, see, here's what you can do. You can do screen position, top, bottom, left, right. I like mine on the right. And now we're gonna go to auto hide. We're gonna have that. And we're gonna go back to the dock settings. And again, I want that to be normal. And I want that to be none. And I want this to all be there. Okay, now, the style, you have so many themes to choose from, There's like 100 themes. Okay, so I'm just gonna put it right back to where it was. The opacity is how much you want. Disable icon labels is so you can't see what's there. You can set a font. I personally love Century Gothic. I use it on almost all pages that I make. So, and you can do the outline color, etc., etc. There could be shadows. Okay, now the behavior is when you click on it, it'll bounce. Okay, and that's just basically it. So, if you need any more, just pop back over to my YouTube account, and if you need any help, just let me know.